the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything that shine ain't always gonna be gold. Hey, I'll be fine once I get it. I'll be good. I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything that shine.
We're gonna start this interview today. Today, September 10th, I have the great benefit of being here with Erwan Lacour. Hopefully, I said your name correctly on that one.
You're fine.
I'm fine. Okay.
Yes.
And it's a great opportunity, and I want the listeners really to take in who we have here today. This man started up his own business called MoveNet, and this is a movement. I don't want to just say a business, a movement, spawning from natural movement. And I really want him to speak a little bit more about what MoveNet is and what his foundation is specifically. What is your vision of being fit?
Being fit, I have a question. When you think of a wild animal, say for instance a tiger, and what is to be fit for a tiger, and what is the best fitness program for a tiger? And then all of a sudden, start smiling because you think like, what? They don't need a fitness program, right? They just need to move the way they do, you know, the way their species move. And why is it that it should be different for us? So to me, to be fit, that's this idea. Human animals should be able to walk and run and climb and jump and move on all fours and balance and lift and throw and carry and catch and defend themselves and swim. You know, that's what means to be fit to me. If to you being fit means looking fit, then you will train in a way that will make look better, not in a way that will make you move and perform better. And so that's where it all starts, a specific mindset. Because if you have a specific perception, then it will just totally influence the way you choose to, you know, to engage in, for instance, in a physical activity, and same goes with any aspect of your life. Natural movement, what is natural movement? What is for us to move naturally? Okay. What is to a tiger or a crocodile, or even a guinea pig, you know, wild guinea pig, of course, not a pet one, to move naturally? But seriously, I mean, all animals, except pets, except domesticated animals, they move naturally in their natural biome. Okay, so we are, if we are animals too, we have the same way to move naturally, which is specific to us, and we should look in that direction to understand what I believe would be the most appropriate fitness regimen for us. I have practiced many different specialized sports and have enjoyed to do that and have learned tremendously from all of these different specialized sports. But I still believe that, at least from my understanding and my personal observation and experience, what is best for us is not a specialized athlete, specialized approach. It is actually a broad approach, because again, natural movement skills, we're talking about jumping, running, climbing, etc., none of them are optional in nature. Yeah, if you find yourself in a situation where you must climb, so for instance, you can find a shelter, you can't see where you are, or you can get food. Mm-hmm. It's not like, oh, you know what, I like to run, but I don't like to climb. Okay, it's not an option. You must do it or else you freaking die. So that is what natural movement is based upon, you know, like movement patterns that are just vital to the human animal. So today, in today's world, we can say, well, you know, yeah, I want to play tennis or do yoga or, you know, choose a specific program or I just want to lift dumbbells or I just want to do push-ups or 10 minutes jog every morning. That's cool, because indeed, when it comes to movement and exercising, everything today is just optional. Mm-hmm. But to our ancestors, and we're talking about our universal ancestors, like Femi, you have your origins in Africa, I have my origins in Africa. Mm-hmm. We all come from the same place. So it's not like we're different. All these are universal patterns and they are universal birthright. So, none of these patterns, none of these skills were optionals. So, my approach is that I maintain that evolutionary birthright of universal human natural movement. I cannot discard any of them. So, a specialized approach to sport, to movement, to exercises, whatever you call it, to me doesn't work. To me, if it makes you happy to just be a marathoner or a tennisman, a rock climber, whatever, it's great. But my experience is that it's not enough to me. It's not satisfying, it's not fun enough. Plus, you tend to be at some point bored, maybe injured. You know, some chronic injuries that are usually specific to every specialized sport and stuff like that. When you have a natural movement, a broad approach of movement, you are never bored. Your motivation is constantly refreshed, and you have this cross training that fortifies your whole body, and you definitely avoid injuries.
I want to paint a picture for the listeners out there. When you hear natural movement, what would they see? You know, I want you to verbally try and paint that picture.
Well, I invite people to remember themselves when they were little, when they were kids. In the park, for instance, or, you know, on vacation by the beach or in the woods, and crawling and running, accelerating, decelerating, mixing jumps, you know, over obstacles, ducking under stuff, switching directions fast, hiding, chasing, climbing, balancing, doing all these things. This is natural movement. Why is it that you used to move this way? When you were kids, because you had instinct, because it's in your genetic program, it's a natural genetic expression. In absolutely all little, you know, small human animals everywhere on the planet, they don't do tennis, they don't do yoga, they don't do Pilates, they don't do bodybuilding, they have or specialized sport, they have, or, you know, they don't do bicep curls or crunches and push-ups. It wouldn't make sense. You would feel really like, how to say, sorry if you were to see young kids doing these things, engaging in this specialized or, you know, like adult kind of physical activity, because you would think, hey kids, you need to move, you know, like you need to play. Why is it that it's different for us? Why? I mean, they're just listening to their nature. Why is it that we are not listening to our nature anymore? Why?
I was doing a bit of research on parkour, I want to know how that overlaps with natural movement and MoveNet. Is there a relationship with that?
There's totally a relationship because, well, parkour was created in France by a friend of mine called David Bell, whose father used to teach him the foundational tenets or principles of what was called méthode naturelle, which goes for natural method. So his dad was a firefighter, and that's a long line of people, you know, that's a long history of physical education in Europe, in France especially, but actually overall in Europe. And MoveNet is also based, at least is greatly inspired by this method, with evolution, with updating many elements of it actually, but it's the same origin and foundation. However, in the process, David skipped many elements that are part of that method and that are part actually of all these vital natural movement skills, such as, for instance, lifting and carrying heavy stuff, throwing, catching heavy stuff, swimming, fighting, and that's a lot, actually, that's a lot. Again, as I said, if you think with a situational mindset, which is after all what parkour practitioners who call themselves stressors are looking for, can you actually discard these skills which are vital and which are, for instance, lifting, carrying heavy stuff or swimming? Isn't something heavy an obstacle or a situation you want to address? Is it swimming across something or having to hold your breath? The kind of situation that would challenge you and which you want to address when you think training. So parkour has become kind of a specialized branch of natural movement. It's not complete anymore.